All the class 10 students of St. Michael's Academy, welcome to another physical science class. In this online physical science class, I am continuing current electricity. Good morning, students. Let's continue. Ohm's law. Ohm's law is a law that states that the voltage across a resistor is directly proportional to the current flowing through the resistance. Ohm's law is named for German physicist George Ohm. A simple formula, Ohm's law is used to show the relationship of current, voltage, and resistance. So, Ohm's law states that the temperature and other physical conditions remaining constant, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the ends of the conductor. So, if I be the current, R be the resistance, and V be the voltage, according to Ohm's law, V varies as I, or V is equal to K into I. K is a constant of proportionality. We find that if V remains unchanged, then I can increase only if K decreases. So K is the opposition to the growth of current. In other words, K is the resistance of the conductor and is represented by R. So that we can say V is equal to I into R, where V is equal to voltage, I is equal to current, and R is equal to resistance. From this equation, we will get I is equal to V by R. That means electric current is equal to voltage by resistance. Now, resistance is defined as the opposition to the flow of electrical current through a conductor. It's important to point out that conductivity and resistivity, the property that determines final resistance, are inversely proportional. The more conductive something is, the less resistance it will have. So if you are not understanding, I'm explaining. The conductor is the ratio. Ratio of the potential difference across the ends of a conductor to the current flowing through the conductor. That means I is equal to V by R. If you know the total current and the voltage across the whole circuit, you can find out the total resistance using Ohm's law, that is R is equal to V by I. So from I is equal to V by R, we can write that R is equal to V by I. The Ohm symbol is there in the bracket, is the SI derived unit of electrical resistance, named after German physicist George Simon Ohm. The graph between V and I is a straight line passing through the origin. The slope of the graph, V by I, gives the resistance R. Unit of resistance is Ohm. So, R is equal to V by I, therefore 1 Ohm. That means, therefore, putting the unit, we will get 1 Ohm is equal to 1 volt by 1 ampere. That means, 1 V A, V for volt, A for ampere, V A inverse or V by A. Thus, resistance of a conductor is 1 Ohm if a potential difference of 1 volt across the ends of the conductor makes a current of 1 ampere to pass through it. Now see the graph. I have plotted V along X axis. I have plotted I along Y axis. So if you draw the graph, you will get a straight line, that is R, or resistance graph. So V versus I graph, where we used to get R, is a straight line. Now, EMF and internal resistance of a cell. The potential difference across the poles of a cell when no current is being taken from it is called the electromotive force or EMF of the cell. If the external resistance is R and the internal resistance is smaller, the total resistance of the circuit is R plus R, so that the current that flows is E by R plus R. Hope so you have understood. If you are not understanding, I am explaining. See, R is the, see the diagram one time. In the circuit where battery sign is there, that is capital R, means E, that is E, that is EMF, and there resistance is also there in the circuit, that is capital R. But within the battery, see battery portion, they have drawn one battery portion, that is small R. So that is internal resistance of the cell. That means when a circuit, we are drawing a circuit, within a battery, that resistance is present, that is small R, and that is internal resistance. And outside the battery, but within the circuit only, there is another resistance, that is capital R. Now, what is E? Here E behaves like V, that means potential difference. And you know V by R is equal to I. That's why, so that the current that flows is I is equal to V by R. That's why here V is equal to E and R is equal to R plus R. That's why E by R plus R is equal to I. Now, what is internal resistance of a cell? Internal resistance refers to the opposition to the flow of current offered by the cell and batteries themselves, resulting in the generation of heat. So, internal resistance is measured in ohms. Resistance is always measured in ohms. Remember this. And within the battery, that resistance present, that is called internal resistance. So, does internal resistance affect EMF? The smaller the internal resistance for a given EMF, the more current and the more power the source can supply. So, internal resistance will decrease, the current flow will increase. Hope so you have understood. So, when current is drawn from a cell, the current flows from anode to cathode in the external circuit and from cathode to anode inside the cell through the electrolyte to maintain a steady and continuous flow. So, outside the cell, current is flowing from anode to cathode, and inside the cell, current is flowing from cathode to anode. The resistance offered by the electrolyte inside the cell to the flow of current is called the internal resistance of the cell. Its unit is ohm. If current I is drawn from the cell of internal resistance small r, the voltage drop is V is equal to I into R. That means it is also obeying Ohm's law. So V, here also potential difference, is equal to I is equal to current, and small r is equal to internal resistance. But here potential difference not, actually it is called voltage drop. V for voltage drop when we are using small r instead of capital R. That means we are using internal resistance instead of external resistance. Now, hope so you have understood the diagram. That's why I have given the diagram. This diagram is not in your book. Hope so you will understand better than your book. Electromotive force EMF is synonymous with voltage. See written here in the diagram. Batteries have an internal resistance small r, which causes a voltage drop, that is V, I into R, small r, when current flows. And the last point, a battery's voltage drop when doing work, called terminal voltage. That means E is equal to I into R plus R. Now, relation between EMF, terminal voltage, and internal resistance. The internal resistance R of a voltage source affects the output voltage when a current flows. The voltage output of a device is called its terminal voltage V, and is given by V is equal to EMF minus I into R. This is a formula where I is the electric current and is positive when flowing away from the positive terminal to the voltage source. Now, the relationship between EMF resistance current and terminal voltage. See the diagram. Circuit model looks like this. Two resistance are there. One is internal resistance, that is battery resistance within the battery, and another one is original resistance of the circuit. Terminal voltage V, V is equal to I into R. Now, E is equal to IR plus I capital R. That is, if we take common, E is equal to I into R plus R. That means R plus R. So, E minus I into small r is equal to V is equal to I into R. That is, I is equal to E by R plus R. Everything I have given. The terminal voltage decrease E minus I into R as the internal resistance R increases or when I increases. So if R is equal to 0, no internal resistance till battery, that is E is equal to I into R. And proof in the next slide, I am making you understand. Now, the proof from your book I am explaining. Let a cell of EMF E and internal resistance small r is connected to an external resistance capital R. Total resistance therefore R plus R. So the current drawn from the cell, it will be I is equal to E by R plus R. Already it has been described. So from here I will get that E is equal to I into R plus R. The terminal voltage of the cell V is equal to I into capital R. And the voltage drop to internal resistance of the cell small v is equal to I into small r. So from this EMF of a cell can also be defined as the work done in carrying a unit positive charge once through a complete circuit, that is external circuit of the cell, and through the electrolyte of the cell is called the electromotive force of the cell. Now again we can write that E is equal to V plus V, that means capital V plus small v. From here we will get small v is equal to E minus capital V. So internal resistance R of the cell is small r is equal to small v by I. Instead of small v, we can write E minus capital V by I is equal to E minus capital V divided by capital V by capital R. That means here first we are putting the value of small v, then we are putting the value of I. So ultimately if we will take common, so a form is coming, that is R into E by V minus 1. I have described and I have explained the proof. If you have not understood this proof, please inform me through my mail ID. Mail ID that is sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com. Then I will send you one video where I will explain this proof. But if you have understood, then very good. Now, factors affecting internal resistance. Larger the separation between the electrodes of the cell, more the length of the electrolyte through which current has to flow, and consequently a higher value of internal resistance. Second one, greater the conductivity of the electrolyte, lesser is the internal resistance of the cell. That is, internal resistance depends on the nature of the electrolyte. Third one, the internal resistance of a cell is inversely proportional to the common area of the electrodes dipping in the electrolyte. Number four, the internal resistance of a cell depends on the nature of the electrodes. So these four points, these are the factors, four factors affecting internal resistance. In a flowchart version also I have given Factors affecting internal resistance of a cell. See, distance between electrodes, area of electrodes, temperature of electrolytes, and concentration of electrolytes. So that easily you can write. If 3 marks question will come, you have to write down all 4 points. But if along with this diagram, but if 2 marks question or 1 marks question will come, then you can show only this chart, a flow chart. Now, resistivity and conductivity. Resistivity is a measure of the resistance to the flow of electrons. Think of a pipe and water. The bigger the pipe, the easier water can flow, and thus the lower the resistance. Conductivity is just the inverse of resistivity. That is, sigma is equal to 1 by rho. This sign is called sigma. S-I-G-M-A, sigma. Equal to 1 by rho. You know already from class 8 that rho is equal to resistivity. So, specific resistance. Remember that where sigma is conductivity and rho is resistivity. Now, see the first diagram. Where sigma is equal to 1 by rho. This is a formula. Now, what is the difference between resistivity and conductivity? Resistivity is a measure of a material's tendency to resist the flow of electrical current. Conductivity is a measure of a material's tendency to allow the flow of electrical current when a potential difference is put across it. So, R is equal to rho into L by A. Hope so you remember class 8. Rho into L by A. L is the length of the conductor. A is the area of cross section of the conductor. And sigma is equal to 1 by rho. So, you can write R is equal to L by rho. Instead of rho, we can put the value 1 by sigma. Rho is equal to 1 by sigma. So, obviously, L by sigma into A ohm. Now, if we draw a graph taking conductivity as x-axis and resistivity along y-axis, so we will get a rectangular hyperbola. See the graph, we will understand. That means, R is equal to rho into L by A, where rho is the constant of proportionality called the resistivity or specific resistance of the conductor. When L is equal to 1, A is equal to 1, then therefore R is equal to rho. Thus, resistivity of a conductor is the resistance of the conductor of unit length and unit area of cross section at a constant temperature. From the definition of resistivity, you can say this. The SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter, and in CGS system it is ohm centimeter. The reciprocal of resistivity is conductivity. Its SI unit is ohm inverse, meter inverse. That means 1 by ohm meter. The reciprocal of ohm is called mho. When you are writing ohm spelling, O-H-M, just from the opposite, read it. It will come MHO, mho, or siemen, that is capital S. So, SI unit of conductivity is siemen meter inverse, or S, capital S, please write, S meter inverse. Small s, please don't write, because small s generally we use for writing displacement. In force and motion chapter, class 9, already you have seen that we used to write small s as displacement. Thank you, students. For any details or queries, please email me at sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com. Today, I have not given you any homework because I want that you will understand this chapter thoroughly. That's why a small portion of this chapter I have given in this slide. Please try to understand, relate this with your book. Hope so you will understand. If you will not understand, if you have any type of doubts or queries, please respond through mail and send me your feedback so that I can make my next slide with your all doubts, or else I can make another video with that proof. Thank you.